So now in Primavera, we will see how to create OBS. OBS in the sense organizational breakdown structure. Actually, in any management, like we will be having one OBS. For example, if you're having one construction, there you might be having one managing director, MD, and then under him, we will be having lots of divisions like design division or estimation division like that. In each divisions, we might be having general managers. So in the division, we also have some other workers. So the chart we can call as OBS chart that we are going to create in Primavera now. So for that, you need to go for Enterprise OBS. And there you can able to add. So you need to click add button. So in order to add an OBS element, the filter will be changed to display all OBS element. You need to click OK. So it will be coming as new OBS, but it is under Enterprise. So you can use this arrow to make it down. So you just make it down and then you can just start creating your own OBS. For example, new construction. And I'm just going for add again. And you can make this arrow to put inside new construction. So this we can make as new construction MD. And then here I'm going for design department. And I'm putting for general manager. And below that, I'm just going for estimation department and general manager. You can go for some other if you need, then you can go for adding. I'm just going to add something below the general manager and I'm just going to use this arrow. So it will be under design department general manager. So I'm just going for worker one and I'm just going for worker two. If you specifically inputting the name also, it's okay. Now, for example, I'm just considering worker one, worker two. And again here, I'm just going to add worker one. So it should be unique. The value entered for OBS name must be unique. So it is automatically considering as worker one by one. Again, I'm just going to put worker two and I'm just going to add. So it will consider automatically the unique name. So better you can input the unique names. If you have same name, then you can put some initials. So it will be perfect in this platform. Okay, now we have created new construction OBS. So if you want to like make everything, you can just minimize. See, it is all in one enterprise actually. That is what we have disadvantage in OBS. There is one enterprise always. So that is called a root OBS. We can't able to delete it. So if you are deleting it, can't delete this row, there must be at least one OBS row. So there will be always a root OBS. In that root OBS only, we can able to add our new OBS. So I'm just going to hide everything and I'm just going to see as a chart view for that. And I'm just going for removing like this one. So we will be having new construction MD all together. And now you can just go for chart view. Now here everything will come. If you don't want, you can delete. This is what the chart view we have. So you can just maximize and see. See here new construction, in that we have a design department manager and estimation department manager and the workers, and you can able to use this icons here also. And I'm just going back for a table view, which means it will go back to the detail view. Okay. Now, if you want to input some changes for a new construction MD, and you can go for description and you can go for modify. And then you can type whatever it is, managing director, something like that. And I'm clicking OK. See, when you're clicking modify, it will be there actually. Click OK. And you can print it and you can copy it. I'm just going for design department general manager. I'm putting modify. And I'm putting general manager. I'm clicking OK. If you want to copy it, you can copy it. And again, I'm going for estimation department. I'm just going to modify and I can paste it. So the description, we can able to copy and paste. For example, if I'm just going for worker one, I'm just going for modify. In this, we can also input the photo of the worker. So you can select the picture icon for selecting the picture and we can go for browsing. And you can take the picture you want. And if you want to specify any alternate text, you can specify here and you can just click OK. So the picture will be here. For example, I have taken. So you should take the picture of the person here, not like this. I'm clicking OK. This is just to print and just to see what is their description, how they look like that. And you can just go for responsibility that we later we will see. For worker 2, I'm just going for modify. These things you can able to like have, for example, like something I'm just putting. And here you can go for left alignment, center alignment, right alignment, like that. I'm putting center alignment. Even you can go for bullet or numbering. This one for one tab. This is like one tab we can able to use. If you don't want, you can just move back also. This is similar to tab that we use in our Word or Excel. Now you also have hyperlink. If you want to link some website or some web link, you can put here. I'm just going to put google.com. Google.com and then I'm clicking OK. You can select the HTTP or HTTPS, whatever it is. Okay, these things you can able to do. If you want to input some mail, you can go for mail too and you can input the mail ID. Now I'm just taking HTTP google.com. I'm clicking OK. So it will come here. So once you're clicking it, it will go to the website. And this one for table, you can specify whatever you want. Serial number. And you can move the table wherever you want within this and you can put center if you want. You just double click and you can edit it. So once you started typing, it will automatically rearrange itself. And then you can go for typing like this. Now in this table, if you want to add more columns, you can click the cursor like this and you can go for right click and you can go for table and then go for insert column and then you can start typing. And again, I'm just going for table and then insert column. If you want to undo, you can go for control Z. Control is it only working for this actually. If you want to delete, you can just go for table and delete row. Now I'm putting here and again going for table. I am going for insert column. I'm just going for 4 and then double click and then name 4. And again, I'm just going for typing everything. So like this also created another row for responsibility. If you want another row, you can just specify here table and then insert row. Okay, now if you don't want, you can delete as well. So everything we have here, like picture, hyperlink and table, you also have that option once you are right clicking into your work area. So I'm just clicking OK. So these options we have seen. Now if you want to like delete, you can just delete here. For example, if I add something here and you don't want that, you can just go for deleting it. Are you sure you want to delete the selected OBS? This can't be undone. You need to put yes. The same you can delete in the keyboard also. For example, you just select it, and then you can go for delete. It will ask you the same. Now you can go for cut. For example, I'm just going for cut here, and again you can click here and you can go for paste. So it will come under that. Again, you can go for copy, and you can go for here and you can paste. So it will come here, but it is coming in a unique name. It by default it is coming. So these things we can able to do in OBS. And now I'm just going for some other options here. There you can go for find. If you want to find some name, for example, I'm putting new and I'm just going for find next. See, it is showing you the details. So like that, you can able to find whatever you want. For example, I'm just going to put Neotech or Neo. I'm just going for find next. So it is going there. It's just for working with our OBS. Sometime we will be having lots of OBS. It is difficult to search, you know. To reduce the time, we will be having this find option as we have in Word. Just you can go for match whole word only or match case everything, and you can go. And I'm just putting cancel now. And now you can go for this arrange children, and these options will be applicable for only the chart view. So again, I'm just going for arrange children, horizontal or vertical or center, left. See, here it is going left, right. So all in right. Now I'm going for details. Here you can go for column, default or users. So you can specify the user here. So that we have in column, default or users. So table, font and row also you can go for. So here you can just go for bold and click apply. Once you apply, everything will change. Even the color you can change. So this is like a background color. And even you can go for changing the row height. And you can go for clicking this. So this icon will go. So without icon, if you want, you can go for. Otherwise, if you want icon, you can specify it. And I'm just clicking OK. And then you can go for filter by current EPS projects or all OBS elements. If you put current EPS projects, only the current open project, that it will show you the OBS list here. So these options we do have in OBS creation. So chart box template, these things only for chart view. So chart box template, you can go for customizing it. This we already seen. If you want, you can go for customize. If you want to add something, you can add, and you can go for description, and the height you can specify. Now I'm clicking OK. So it will change. It also show you the description. And short font and colors you can go. If you want to make it some other color, you can make it and apply. It will change. And you can just go for font, and then you can go for apply. You can able to see all these things. It's changing. So this we do have in OBS creation in Primavera. So like this, you can able to create your OBS.